Hi there. Today we are going to look at setting up a tombstone and how Cam Assist can help with this process. We've got a tombstone set up with a part in two orientations, the top and the bottom. We are going to use Cam Assist to generate the toolpaths for the top and bottom sides of the part, and then we will use the Toolpath Transform tools in Mastercam to complete all of the operations. For each side of the part, we are going to use a separate master model and rectangle stock body. There is not a lot of rest machining between these two operations, so we aren't going to use a mesh stock model in this case, although we could. We've also set up the work holding to include the part body for the bottom side, so we won't get any collisions. Now let's open Cam Assist. We are going to use the demo inch tools for this example, and the machining mode will be 3+2 automatic due to the geometry of the part. We are only going to check part top op 1 for the setups, as we only want to run the top part at this time. We will also select the avoidance geometry to help prevent the tool pads from generating under the part. We are running this part as generic aluminum, and we don't have to make any other changes. Let's hit run. We've sped up the playback speed a bit for this video, but as you can see, Cam Assist has really helped us to speed through the tool path creation process so far. We also need a bit of time to generate the tool paths in Mastercam. We've skipped ahead past that process, but it was only a few minutes long. At this stage, we want to check and verify the generated tool paths. These look great. Once we are happy, we are going to lock all of the operations in the first machine group. This will help Mastercam compute a bit more efficiently when we calculate machine group 2. To do this, select the tool paths and then click the lock button. We will also collapse machine group 1 up just to keep things tidy. Let's look at the configuration for machine group 2 now. This will be for the other side of the part mounted to the bottom of the tombstone. As mentioned, we have a different master model and stock body for this part. We also need to specify the fixture bodies appropriately and include the top part to avoid collisions. We also selected the bottom plate to further constrain the 3+2 tool paths. We didn't want to generate tool pads coming from that side of the work coordinates. Now we are all set to run Cam Assist on the second machine group. We will run virtually the same Cam Assist settings that we used for machine group 1. However, we will select the second operation in the setup section. We also need to ensure that the top plane is selected. Once again, we will speed up the video slightly for the processing. Skipping ahead past toolpath generation in Mastercam, we can unlock the machine group 1 operations and look at all of the toolpaths for one side of the tombstone. Next, we are going to make a toolpath group just for the transformed toolpaths. This isn't required, but we find it helps to keep the Mastercam file organized. We will call this toolpath group transformations. We will also move it after the last toolpath group. Next, we will select toolpath transform from the Mastercam toolpath menu. This will open the Transform Operation Parameters modal, where we will have a number of configurations to choose from. In this case, our goal is to pattern the toolpaths from Machine Group 1 and Machine Group 2 around the tombstone 3 more times at 90-degree increments. For more information on using Toolpath Transform in Mastercam, consult your reseller or information on My Mastercam. In this case, we selected back for the rotation plane, as this is how the patterning we want was aligned. One tip we like to do with transformations is to just choose one tool path to start, to check that all of the parameters are correct Once satisfied, we add the other operations to the source operations area. In this case, we just ran the first facing operation. Make sure generate toolpath is checked and click the green check button. Now we can see the facing operation has been patterned around the tombstone properly. We will edit the transformation toolpath and select all of the operations from machine group 1 and machine group 2 and recalculate. This process is quite fast if you are patterning NC operations, so no video speed ups were used here. Here we see all of the transform toolpaths around the tombstone. We didn't use Cam Assist for the entire process, but for the initial toolpath generation, it was a big help. Using a tombstone is a great method for batch processing and light production runs. Even if you have different parts around the tombstone, Cam Assist can be used to generate the operations. Combined with toolpath transform in Mastercam, Cam Assist can really speed up your programming for batch production jobs like this. Let us know if you found this video useful, and stay tuned for more tips and tricks from CloudNC.